Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and I want to explain how KD trees work by inserting some data into a KD tree so that you can see the structure. Now, the idea of the KD tree is that it is a two-dimensional, it's a binary tree. It's a binary tree. And the K stands for the number of dimensions that you have in the tree. So in the case of this place where I'm going to lay down my data here, I have two dimensions, X and Y. So my KD tree will be a 2D tree, K equals 2. And the idea is when you, every time you step down a level in the tree, you toggle which dimension you use to make your decision. So let's go ahead and start doing this. And I'm going to be drawing the points on the screen also as I'm creating the tree. So my first data item here is 3, 7. So here's my 3, 7 right here. And I'm inserting that into an initially empty tree. And so I insert it, I'm going to color it red for a reason you'll see in just a minute. So I'm inserting it here, 3, 7, to this node right here. Okay, the next node that I'm going to be inserting then will use that 3, the first dimension, to decide whether I go to the left or to the right. So my next node that I want to insert is 8, 1, and here's my 8, 1 right here. I compare my 8 with my first dimension, and I see that 8 goes to the right. So I'm going to put the node to the right of that, and it's a leaf level. So here's my 8, 1 right here. Okay, now this is colored blue because if I may have to make a decision at this point, I'll be deciding on the second dimension. Red means I'm deciding at that point on the first dimension. Okay, the next data I want to insert is 6, 6. 6, 6 is located right here on my graph. The 6 is greater than the 7, right? This 6 right here is greater than this 3. I use the first dimension, so I go to the right. And then I use this 6 right here and compare it against the 1, and it's greater than the 1, so I will go to the right again. And every time I go down a level, I need to toggle my color between my blue and red. So here is where my 6, 6 goes. Just as a recap, if I'm searching for 6, 6, I compare the first 6 against the 3, and that says go to the right. I compare the second 6 against the 1, and that says go to the right. So here I'm deciding on X, and here I'm deciding on Y. And then again, decide X at this level. Okay, the next piece of data that I'm inserting is a 2, 6. 2, 6 needs to go right here. Okay, so the 2 is compared against the 3, and 2 is less than 3. So I'll insert it right there, at that leaf level right there. 2, 6. Okay, next I have 1, 7. 1, 7 is here. Now let's insert it to the tree. First I compare the 1 against the 3. 1 is less than 3, so I go to the left. Now I compare the 7 against the 6. This 7 right here against this 6. 7 is greater than 6, so I go to the right. I'm at leaf level, so I can insert my 1, 7 right here. Okay, next I have 8, 6. 8, 6 is going here. Okay, so let's go ahead and insert it. 8 is greater than 3, so I go to the right. 6 is greater than 1, so I go to the right. 8 is greater than 6, so I go to the right. And I will now have a blue node here. So there's my 8, 6. Okay. Then my last piece of data to insert is 5, 9. 5, 9 is going here on my grid, belongs there on my grid. Okay, let's insert. 5 is greater than 3, so I go to the right. 9 is greater than 1, so I go to the right. 5 is less than 6, so I go to the left. Okay, let's suppose, just for example, that I want to search for 1, 7. Okay, 1, 7 is what I'm looking for. 1, 7 right here. Okay, 1 is less than 3, so I go left. 7 is greater than 6, so I go right. And there's my node. Let's suppose that I want instead to search for 5, 2, which we can see is not in the tree, but let's see if we can find it. I'm searching for 5, 2. 5 is greater than 3, so I go to the right. 2 is greater than 1, so I go to the right. 5 is less than 6, so I go to the left. 2 is less than 9, I look to the left, null. So 5, 2 does not appear in the tree. Okay.